From Universal Studios in Hollywood, California, it's Home and Family. Today on the show, actress Julie Benz, and from Marry Me, Sarah Wright Olson. From our house to yours.
Brighten up your day, the Home and Family way.
Welcome to Home and Family. You're part of our family, and now you're at our home, and we welcome you with open arms.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah, we do, and it's another beautiful day up here, and I'm really super excited because we have a really jam-packed show and a very special guest today that I found myself personally. So I'm going to share with you in a second.
Well, let's start with actress Julie Benz. She is back with us today. She's talking about her new hit show, Defiance, on the Sci-Fi Channel. She's also very thrifty. I understand you were in the kitchen, and you're not repurposing, but...
You're repurposing food?
Food, sort of.
Yeah. Sort of. Yeah. Using, you know how at the holidays you always have those leftover cans of pumpkin in your pantry? So I'm using pumpkin in my turkey chili.
And they usually show up 6 years later and you go, well, look at this, and it hasn't expired yet. You know, it's like 2020.
Yeah. You know what? I may have to do this because when I have leftover pumpkin, it usually goes to Fred, my dog.
Yeah, that's another way. I do that too.
He does. He loves pumpkin.
Pumpkin's very good for dogs,
actually. Very good.
It is very good
filler.
For
you. He'll eat anything. He's a counter surfer, that dog. He really is. He goes and goes, all right, well, we're going to have some pumpkin chili. Yeah. Is it spicy? Can you make it spicy?
You can make it spicy.
Ooh. Mm-hmm.
And speaking of spicy, okay, here we go. All right. So,
hang on. We still want to talk about our other guest who's going to be here. She's not here right now.
Yeah.
I know where you're going.
Yeah. Well, she said spicy. I had to go with it. Okay. All right. So also later, also, we're very happy to have NBC's new comedy, Marry Me, Sarah Wright Olson with us. And she's going to tell us about the show and share some fun stories about being a new mom. She's pretty spicy herself.
She's spicy herself. Now go ahead.
Okay. But really spicy. A few months ago, I was at St. Sophia's, which is a Greek church here in Los Angeles. And there was a police force was there, and our firefighters were there, too. And I noticed a tall, nice, good-looking gentleman with big blue eyes and blonde hair wearing a fireman's uniform. And I went, by the side, I want you to take a look at the name right here. It says Ferrari. Hello? Ferrari on it. Okay. So, not only that, I have a nephew named Daniel. His name is Daniel, Daniel Ferrari. And Kim, get away from him.
What do you mean?
This is Daniel Ferrari from Pico Union Station number 13 here in California. So welcome, Daniel.
Thank you.
Daniel, we asked him to come on. We have a little tape of us at the fire station, but we asked him to come on this morning, and he just came from fighting a huge fire downtown. Right, Daniel?
Yeah.
What's going on down there?
You've been up since what hour were you called to this fire?
About 2.
About 2 a.m.
Yeah, that's kind of normal where we work, so.
So this is the actual fire. Look at that. Yeah, that's where you were?
This morning.
Wow.
That's How long did you battle that?
My contribution was about an hour and a half. It was actually 4 buildings that caught fire within about a 90-minute period. 3 right close to each other, and then there was another one about a mile away. And it took 350 firefighters about 5 hours total to get the whole thing out.
Wow.
Luckily, no one was hurt. And,
well, you know, I know it probably isn't said enough, but, you know, whether it's a fireman or a police officer, thank you for your service to our community.
Because Daniel.
Without you guys out there, that's not safe. Those jobs are not safe. And
without you, we wouldn't have a job, so.
Yeah.
We bonded on a lot of levels, but one of the things that we really bonded on was cooking. He loves to cook, so it got me starting, like, what do you cook at the fire station? What do you do at Christmas time? And so a little Miss Kim Douglas and I, what did we decide to do?
We went to the fire station.
You say that like you won the lottery.
It was so fun. We almost moved in, right?
Yeah.
Literally.
Made yourself right at home.
Yeah.
And then some.
Yeah, well, we brought some. Well, we brought a little tape of us. We're going to show you later of us at the fire station, including something very special that I'm sure is everybody's fantasy.
Yeah.
Slide down the pole. And I'm not going to tell you who did it. I'm not going to tell you which one of us did it.
It was Mark.
Daniel, first, you're going to cook for us, though, today? Or are you going to get in the kitchen?
It'll be an attempt.
It'll be an attempt.
Yeah. But I'm excited. It'll be fun.
Do you cook for everybody in the firehouse?
I do. It's usually a team effort because we're so busy. When some go out the door, some jump in the kitchen. We're doing an assembly line if we're all together. But yeah, every night we at least cook dinner together as a family.
And what are you going to make for us today?
I'm going to do my Christmas enchiladas.
And you have a special name for them, right?
I was put up to this, but I call them the Feliz Navidades.
Look how delicious they look. No, it's okay.
Cheesy, I know.
You need to own it. You need to own it and welcome. Okay, it's good to have you here. Okay.
We're also excited, as if we couldn't get even more handsome on the show. We're going to shove some in here for you. We're happy to welcome back to the show three-time Emmy Award-winning vocal group, the Texas Tenors are back. This is sort of the man show today, right? Look at this. You're performing for us today, guys. What are you going to sing?
We're actually going to be singing Feliz Navidad. It's the new enchilada song of the season. I mean, I don't know how he got a hold of the rest of me, but it was a song first. I don't know how that happened, but yeah. A couple of Christmas classics and a very emotional ballad. It means a little bit of something to Christina, we heard.
It does. Yeah. It just wrecks me every time I hear it.
We're going to give you a new reason to like it, though.
Well, thank you. It is because my first ex-boyfriend dumped me, and that was our song. It makes me sad.
Well, if you have little ones at home, you don't want to miss this. This is a very special performance today coming up. Yeah. Also, if you have little ones at home today, you're going to want to catch what Tanya Meme has for us, right?
Yes. Hi, Tanya. Yes. Wow. It is very spicy on set, you guys. It's hard for me to focus with all this going on here. But
anyway,
who doesn't love themed Christmas sweaters, right? Everybody does. So I'm going to show you how to make your own for under 15 bucks. Super cheap, super fun to make. And they're for kids. Who doesn't love that? Coming up in my segment.
All right, it's not too late to take advantage of affordable winter getaways, and our travel expert trio, they're back to give us some great ideas. Please welcome Carolyn Scott Hamilton, Donna Perkins, and Tracy O'Connor. Welcome back, ladies.
Hi, ladies. So I understand the options you have for us are going to take us everywhere from the ski slopes to the beach. Is that right?
Yep. I've got somewhere warm and exotic, and I'm also sharing someplace a little chilly but iconic.
And I am going to take you to some exotic locations, but it's not going to break the bank.
And I am going to show you a great trip for the city slicker and one for the outdoor adventure.
Great. Wow.
Speaking of, I know that. Yeah, no, I know. We're going to follow Daniel, too, because he travels a lot as well.
Yeah.
You know, many of us attend holiday parties, and sometimes we have maybe a little bit too much fun, and we may be overserved sometimes, and the next morning you end up with a colossal headache and a hangover. We're here. Dr. Matt Eisman is with us to help us with some remedies. Welcome, doctor.
Well, looking at this group, I don't think anyone here has ever had a hangover, except for maybe Kim Douglas. I want to party with you, Kim.
And that's when I'm not even drinking, right? That's just...
We're going to be talking about what is a hangover, what the best cures are, and we're going to be telling you all the myths. Are they true or are they false?
Okay.
I love how you politely put that. When they're overserved.
Yeah,
it's a way of not taking responsibility, right? Here taking full responsibility of her actions because she's so wonderful stuff to use today. Vinegar, really unique uses for vinegar. Right. Sophie Iuliano. Hi, Sophie.
Hey, Mark. Hi. Yes, so I've got some really fascinating uses for vinegar. How to clean your silver jewelry, your coffee maker, in a pinch to use it as a deodorant to cure hiccups. You're going to have to watch what I've got in store for you.
Wow, hiccups. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, great. And you also have to here with a great holiday gift idea, too, right, Sophie?
I'm so excited to share this with you. I'm going to tell you what my favorite holiday gift is, why I love it so much, and how you can win it.
Yeah. Well, I have to tell you, it's a good, every day has been great, but this is something that's spectacular.
Well, it's a good opportunity to remind everybody that we have teamed up with Publishers Clearinghouse. I can actually talk today. We're giving away $5,000 a day for 5 days to 5 lucky home and family viewers. One of those could be you. It's simple to find out how to play by going to our Facebook page, or you can go to pch.com/Hallmark. All the information is there for you to sign up. $5,000 a day.
Who wants $5,000 in the audience?
Yeah.
Right? Anybody?
That'll pay all
Call